designing the StoryBots world was one of the most awesomely fun projects ever. So we knew that they lived inside these super high-tech devices, and within these high-tech devices, we wanted it to be ultra lo-fi, which means vacuum tubes, things duct taped together.
Yeah, Evan sent like a bunch of very specific imagery.
Switching stations and wires everywhere, early telephone switchboard operators. NASA during the 1950s and 60s was super cool. And basically I called everyone I knew whose work I loved and I said, hey, what does this look like?
When I started the first day on BizDev, I just hit the ground running and I was super excited to be able to draw.
I think at a bigger studio, that doesn't always get to happen. There's a bigger team. And we had a very small and intimate team, and I was really happy to be able to do that.
There were hundreds and hundreds, and probably into the thousands of drawings by some of the best artists in the universe. Ultimately, once we started producing the show, we had to pick. And I kept returning to this one drawing that Eddie West did, and you could feel the drawing and you could feel personality in it.
And then I also kind of thought about just gags that you could put into the backgrounds, just like silly things.
Eventually, once Eddie had nailed down what the line work would be, I took some of those drawings and started plugging in different color options and trying to figure out what would work. We probably went through more than 40 different color passes before we landed on what the show looks like now.
Everything about the StoryBots world had to feel like there were humans that crafted this thing. And that goes through the entire production.